Hey everybody, Jason Schneider here, founder of PerceptionAcademy.com, and today I wanted to share with you one of the biggest values that NLP provides, and one of the biggest keys to practicing NLP. So stay tuned. So one of the biggest values that NLP provides is the understanding and the practice that excellence and even genius can be modeled, can be replicated by breaking it down into small pieces and then by finding out the sequence of those little steps, step by step by step. And really, NLP is the only discipline, neurosemantic NLP even more specifically, is the only discipline that allows us to do this at such a micro level that we're able to model out and replicate the excellence of somebody, even what happens in a split second, unconsciously, in between a stimulus and the person's response. So typically when we're confronted with stimulus, we respond immediately, almost immediately. And in that fraction of a second, there is a lot of processing that happens in between people's, inside of people's mind-body system. And most people move through the world just focusing on the behavior of people. So they're just seeing this stimulus response world. They're living in this primary stimulus response world. But as neuro-linguistic programmers, as neuroseminticists, we can train ourselves to actually recognize the layers and layers and layers of the matrix that are occurring within everybody's mind-body system that's actually governing all of these behaviors if you only have the eyes and the ears to see and hear it. So NLP actually provides us with the technology to recognize and to model out and even replicate those experiences in ourselves. If somebody else is able to do something that we're not, the presupposition of neuro-linguistic programming is that we are able to model that, and we can model that, and when we do, we will have the same experience that that person has. So this is just a super powerful understanding, idea, and practice. And the fact that these experiences can be modeled, when we're talking about excellence and even genius, it's just when we think about the ability for us to grow as human beings or as a human race, as a self-actualizing community, our evolution accelerates dramatically when we're able to pick and choose and cherry pick the best of the best of the best and replicate that in ourselves rather than just being trapped in our family community, being able to do what we kind of picked up automatically from our family or what we picked up from the communities that we grew up in. When, especially in today's interconnected world with access to the internet, with access to YouTube, like you're here now probably watching me, or Facebook, that we have the ability to find experts and people who do things that amazingly well and be able to replicate that excellence in ourselves, especially when we utilize and leverage the tools that neuro-linguistic programming, neuro-semantics provides for that. So we have the ability to model excellence. And like I said in one of the previous presuppositions, that even the things that we do that are unresourceful, that we sometimes think that we're broken or we're doing things that don't serve us, even those skills, they work perfectly well and they are examples of excellence. And so we can model excellence in terms of genius or excellence in order, you know, actually resourceful excellence in order to replicate that from other people or even from our own past experiences, like I talked about in another video, that we're able to, and I'll share a link with you underneath this video for those other videos that I'm referencing. But we're able to even go back into our past and harvest our own resourceful experiences and model those to utilize them in our lives. But in terms of unresourceful experiences that we do excellently, we're able to, when we can create a model of how that experience works, we're able to experientially find the leverage points to transform those experiences in ways that are extremely precise to transform them into completely different experiences that are aligned with our outcomes and our intentions, or if we're a coach or an NLP practitioner or neurosemanticist, in ways that are aligned for our clients with their outcomes and their intentions. So this is something that's huge. I think a lot of neuro-linguistic programmers or neurosemanticists or coaches in general, people helpers of all kinds, don't fully grasp this or don't fully leverage the value of this within the field of NLP and the value of being able to model and replicate excellence, as well as the ability to model excellence in order to model unresourceful excellence in order to find out what are the leverage points so that I can transform this experience so that it doesn't work quite the same, and even so that I can transform this experience into exactly what I want it to be. So I hope you found this video valuable. I really enjoyed making this video for you. And definitely, as always, feel free to question and comment below. Share with me your feedback. I love to support you more and more on your journey to mastering yourself, mastering your mind, mastering your perception, and mastering your ability to facilitate people to unleash their potential as well as your own.